The Kenyan police has announced it has arrested 61 people on Saturday and the wee hours of Sunday morning, including a policeman, in the wake of the onslaught, which they feared could further inflame tensions between the rival Orma and Pokomo communities in the area. Police attributed the killings to a disarmament operation in the area, but the violence could also be linked to the election being held next March, the first since Kenya was gripped by deadly inter-ethnic killings after a December 2007 vote. Police said the dead in Kipao included 16 children, 5 women and 10 men, along with 14 assailants. Kenya votes on March 4th in its first elections since the disputed 2007 vote, which led to the worst inter-ethnic violence since independence, with more than 1,100 people killed and hundreds of thousands displaced. Two of the candidates running for the presidency are Prime Minister Raila Odinga, who lost his bid in the 2007 vote, and Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta, who has been indicted by the International Criminal Court for his alleged role in the violence which shattered Kenya's image as a beacon of regional stability. With renewed tribal violence in the southeast, riots in Mombasa and attacks in Nairobi, many ordinary people fear that the country will see a repeat of the violence that erupted after the 2007 election.
Unless something is done to assist people in terms of reconciliation, in terms of peaceful coexistence, there is going to be high tension as we get into the March pause.
Let us not fight. Let us not fight. Because they tasted the bitter pill in 2007. So those who are going to do what they did in 2007 will be checked on their track. Yeah. Because nobody, no Kenyan wants war unless planned by, like the likes planned it in 2007. But see, now people are aware. So there's the deliberate move to stop it. Raila is seasoned, I told you. He's quite seasoned, he's experienced. He is calm, so to speak. Uhuru is experienced, but he still has a long way to go, in my opinion, in terms of convincing people about his whole being as a politician. He has questions to answer, and the world is watching.
Since the last 2008 election violence, I think Kenyans have been sitting on a time bomb, and there has not been peace. It's only that people have been pretending that there's peace, but there's no peace. And we are heading to a more problematic times, more than 2007, if we don't make the right decision.
Prime Minister Raila Odinga and his deputy Uhuru Kenyatta will both contest presidential elections on March 4th. Odinga, 67, and Kenyatta, 51, were both key players in a presidential polling crisis 5 years ago that descended into an orgy of inter-ethnic violence.